Welcome to the Selling Without Selling Toolbox, brought to you by Business Development Machine and CPA Network. Socratic Method of Selling, Part 1, Setting the Stage of Listening to Understand. The Greek philosopher, Socrates, used a method of teaching or discussion in which one asks a series of easily answered questions that inevitably lead the answerer to a logical conclusion. It's a conversation or discussion leading to understanding. Note, this is not an interrogation to gather information leading to a sale or something that fits in with your own ulterior motives. This discipline method is used to pursue thought in many directions and for many purposes, including to get to the truth of things, to open up issues and problems, to uncover assumptions, and to distinguish what we know from what we don't know. Socratic questioning illuminates the importance of questioning and learning, while allowing individuals to understand the root of their knowledge, ideas, perceptions, and belief systems. In the selling without selling process, we use the Socratic method to quickly build relationships of willingness and trust, while empathizing with others deeply. Listening effectively as you ask the right questions is crucial. The goal is to establish a relationship with the client, so they become aware of their pain and the gap between where they are and where they would really like to be in terms of quality of life and the requisite income to achieve and maintain it. Coupling the selling without selling process and the Socratic method of selling, we start with a mindset of completely letting go of our own personal needs and wants, including your need to land the sale. We call this coming with an empty cup. We use an ancient Zen belief that if you truly seek understanding, then first, you must empty your own cup. This way of thinking will allow you to completely focus and listen with empathy to the prospect, client, friend you are meeting with to learn their plans, needs, desires, and to understand who they really are on a human level. Three key attitudes to using the Socratic method of questioning: a willingness to respect the potential buyer, client; a willingness to allow potential buyer, client to think; a willingness to allow the potential buyer, client to make decisions. Step 1, setting the stage for a successful Socratic conversation. Objective: to rapidly develop a relationship of trust and hope with even a skeptical stranger. Every meeting should begin with a version of your opening statement. Key: the purpose of the opening statement is to consciously remove selling pressure, allowing you both to feel more at ease. A simple Socratic method opening statement example. Socratic questioner: thank you for meeting with me today. I'd like to ask you some questions to better understand your goals, your business, and any issues or obstacles to your progress. Then we can discuss if and how we might address those issues. You can decide if it makes sense. May I ask you some questions? Do you mind if I take notes? Step 2. Everyone is an expert in themselves and happy to share it. Just ask. You will be surprised how willing someone can be to share their story and secrets with you when they feel safe. Key: the focal point of this process is uncovering their plans and examine limiting belief systems. The golden selling without selling Socratic opening question starter. It's important to set the stage so the potential buyer client does not feel uncomfortable, defensive, or feel guarded. Socratic questioner: in 2,000 words or less, can you please share with me your journey through the business world that brought you to the chair you sit in today? Later in the conversation, stimulate their understanding of where they would like to be in the future. Listen closely to their journey as they talk about themselves, remembering it's more important to understand than to persuade. With our process, potential buyer clients persuade themselves. The key is to listen, find, and understand the issues and pains that are important to them. Make it their meeting. Allow them to tell their story. Take notes of what you learn to explore later. Key: it's never about you. It must be all about them. In order to do that, you have to come around to their side of the desk and see the problems from their point of view. You must come to feel their problems just the way they feel them. This Socratic conversation starter is meant to allow them to come into an awareness of what he or she have not achieved, and helping them quantify what that lack is costing them in terms of income and quality of life. The past is full of many successes and mistakes. Let them interpret it all to you. The beauty of this part of the conversation is that the potential buyer client owns the past. They will have no stake in the future until the past has been dealt with. Tying in process, in all areas of discovery, it is imperative that you bring specific problem issues down to the level of impact on their personal lives and the pain they feel from that impact. If the prospect feels no pain, they have no reason to move. Use Socratic method questioning to probe and go deeper. You must overcome any personal fear or reluctance to connect on this level. It is easy to bind to the prospect's reality. You must be willing to be vulnerable to connect at this level. Here are some Socratic probing questions. Tell me more about, would you elaborate on, give me an example of, what else should I know about, what else would help me understand? Here is a deeper use of Socratic questioning. If you had more income, what are some of the things you and your family would be doing? How does fit the picture? Talk to me about your experience with, how do you handle? Step 2. Believe that the sale is being made when the customer speaks about the need. Remember, the customer's feelings determine the buying decision. Note, this is the heart of the process. People do not buy from us because they understand our services. They buy from us because they feel like we understand them and that they feel that they are better off with us than without us. It is through Socratic questioning that we create this understanding emotionally. Be aware of what is not being said. Listen and question with interest and concern. Receptive listening helps others make certain discoveries and encourages him or her to engage in your services. The trained Socratic questioner uses not only the verbal communications, but also nonverbal communications. This includes recognizing unconscious signals that other people are sending, as well as understanding facial expressions, body language, and the implications behind the words. Use receptive listening questions. Responsive reinforcement is helpful in fostering learning. This skill is shown through praise, positive comments like, uh-huh, playback, nod, show of approval. Really, that's interesting. Can you be more specific? You feel strongly about it. How important is that to you? Tell me more about it. The more reinforcement, the more the prospect expands and participates. The Socratic questioner might say, do I hear you telling me, then you feel, let's see if I'm tracking the way you feel about it. Are you saying, in other words, what you mean then is my understanding correct? The Socratic questioner also uses opinion questions, such as, what is it that you'd like your business to provide you with that it's not? Do you find this to be true? How do you feel about this? Do you feel this is a problem? Are you concerned about this? Is this important to you? What do you think? What's your thinking on this problem? Why do you say that? Socratic questioner uses irritant questions. What bothers you most about this? I sense you're frustrated by this. What you're saying is that if this trend continues, you could lose it all. Use the Socratic method to motivate with questions like, how does this affect you? I sense this means a lot to you. Why is this important to you? Step 3. Sales are closed when the potential buyer client feels you understand them. It is in the discovery process that we model this understanding and their emotional decision to hire us is made. Ask feel-finding questions and questions that are open-ended to help the prospect get in touch with their feelings as to what is not happening for them. Get specifics, but be aware. Do not bandage. Allow the pressure to build. The more you help them to understand, the more they are motivated to engage you. The better the listener you are with the potential buyer client, the better the listener they become when it is your turn to talk. Key: you haven't listened until you can show you have listened. This video is just part one. Look for other Socratic method selling videos in our Selling Without Selling Toolbox series, designed to further your understanding of creating high-value relationships with select clients. For more information, visit www.cpanetwork.org and www.businessdevelopmentmachine.com.